Hi everybody, my name is Victoria. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm really excited to talk about all of my December reading plans. I'm trying to participate in two different holiday readathons, and funny enough, they both are reindeer themed. I didn't really plan that. It just happened to be that both of these readathons I just really wanted to do. And so I'm doing both the reindeer readathon and also the reindeer games readathon. So I found out about the reindeer readathon from Amanda's channel, and it is hosted by her and also Eric and a bunch of other people. I'm gonna link them all down below so you can check out their announcement videos. This is a bit of a competitive readathon where you are earning points for your team. I'm on Amanda's team. I'm really excited about that. We are Team Candy Cane. So we've got this. We're gonna do amazing. And there's a bunch of different prompts with different reindeers attached to the prompts, and they're each worth different points. There's also gonna be a few fun events like a Christmas card exchange, and I'm so pumped for that. I just wanna do all the Christmassy things this year. Some years I don't care that much about Christmas, but this is not that year. This year I want all the Christmas. So I'm just so excited for this one. It's got a lot of things going on, and it's gonna be super fun. The other reindeer readathon I'm gonna be doing is the Reindeer Games Shelf Space Book Club readathon. And this is also a competitive readathon, and all the teams are competing against one another. I'm on Team Charlie Brown. I'm really excited because my team is awesome. I have Jessie May on my team, who is the creator of this readathon. So super excited about that. So kind of the same deal with that readathon. There's different prompts. I'm not sure I'm gonna do as well on those prompts because I found out about that one later than I did the reindeer readathon. So I kind of planned my TBR a little bit more around the reindeer readathon, but I think some of my books are still gonna fit for the reindeer games readathon as well. This is taking place in Jessie May's Discord channel. I will link that down below for you as well. In addition to Jessie May's channel, if you're not familiar with her, she is amazing. Also throughout this video, if I start jingling, it's because I have actual jingle bells on the shirt. So if I start jingling in the middle of talking about a book, it's because it's my shirt. All right, diving into the TBR. So the first book that I plan on reading is Dawn Shard by Brandon Sanderson. Dawn Shard is a novella in the Stormlight Archives. It comes after Oathbringer and before Rhythm of War. I haven't read Rhythm of War yet. I'm planning on reading Dawn Shard first. For the Reindeer Games readathon, this is gonna fit the novella or short story collection prompt. And then for the Reindeer readathon prompt, this is gonna fit a genre you love, or the Cupid prompt, and I love fantasy, so I thought this would be perfect for that prompt. The next book on my TBR is Rhythm of War, of course. If you haven't heard about Rhythm of War, you're probably not on BookTube. Everybody's been talking about this. It is quite hyped, and it is the fourth new release in the Stormlight Archives series. I'm not sure what prompt this is gonna fulfill for the Reindeer Games readathon. I'm not sure it fits one. I'm going to ask Jessie about that, but I might consider it for one of the prompts. I just have to figure out if it fits in one. I'm not quite sure. But for the Reindeer readathon, this is gonna fit into the Comet prompt, and that is a book that intimidates you, which of course this intimidates me. It's only 1,219 pages or so. So yes, definitely an intimidating one. If I only read Dawn Shard in this, I won't be surprised. I'm gonna try to read other books too. I have quite an unrealistic TBR, to be honest, but this is definitely gonna happen in December. Another book that I would like to try and read in December is The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue by V.E. Schwab. This is also extremely beloved and hyped right now. From what I understand, this is a fantasy romance. It's got a plot about this girl who is forgotten the minute you look away from her. She can interact with people. She's somehow immortal, and when she interacts with them, they will not remember her. This is part of how she is cursed. For the Reindeer Games readathon, this is fitting a book with romance in it. And for the Reindeer readathon, it's going to be a strong female protagonist, or the Vixen prompt. I've heard lots of wonderful things about this so far. I know Jessie from Bookish Bomb really loved this book. I've seen a few other people. Oh, Stephanie from Mrs. Richards Reads also loved this book, so I'm really excited to give it a try and see what I think. The next book that I'm hoping to get to, and I don't actually have a copy of it yet, but that's Piranesi by Susanna Clark. This is the buddy read for Michael Knipp's Patreon group, and I'm trying to be participating in those. I've been doing pretty okay. I've just skipped a couple that I just got behind on, but Piranesi is pretty short, and from what I've heard, it's fantastic, and I definitely want to try to squeeze this in if I can. All I know about this book is that you don't want to know a lot. Something about a labyrinth, something about mythology and mythical creatures, and it's in a fantastical house, I think. I've heard people say that the less you know about this book, the better, and so I'm purposefully not trying to learn anything about it. So it made it hard to kind of fit this into a prompt without knowing much about it. But for the Reindeer Games readathon, I'm going to go with a book with elves or fae or other magical beings. I'm thinking there's magical beings in this if it's centered around mythology. And then for the Reindeer Readathon, it's going to be for the Dasher prompt, which is read a book with a one-word title. This next book pick is actually going to be a surprise. It's a mystery book pick. And the reason it's going to be a secret for now is that this is part of a Secret Santa read. The amazing Andy created a Secret Santa book event for us, which was really awesome of him. And I'm super excited. When I heard about it, I was like, yes, I want to do that. So I'm definitely going to be reading this mystery book for sure. This is a priority book. We were all assigned a specific booktuber who we are supposed to keep a secret, and we are supposed to read a favorite book of theirs. And I kind of laugh at this because it is a book that I had really no intention of reading and was maybe a little bit biased against. But I'm gonna give it a try. Who knows, maybe it'll become a favorite of mine. We will see, but I'm really excited for this. It's a great way to, I think, get us out of our shells and try different things that maybe we wouldn't have tried otherwise. And so I will be revealing who my Secret Santa buddy was on December 21st with a video, and I'll do a book review of this book and then a Secret Santa reveal. So I'm super excited for this. But here's some hints. These are the prompts that this book is going to fulfill, I think. For Reindeer Games, I'm gonna go with book set in a forest. Although I could be wrong about this, I'm just not sure. I think there's a forest in the book. I'm not sure if that's maybe stretching it. Not sure if the whole book is set in a forest, but we're gonna go with that for now. And then for the Reindeer Readathon, this is gonna be a book with some sort of struggle for the Blitzen prompt. And that is because there is a competition involved in this book. So those are your clues. See if you can guess what the book is. But all will be revealed on December 21st. The next book that I'm planning on picking up is A Christmas Wish. I really wanted to read something Christmassy, maybe a light-hearted romance, and this really fit the bill for me. I wanted to read this for Rainy and Angie's book club that they do, Bitter Single Ladies Read Romance, I believe is what it's called. I've been wanting to participate in this book club, just hadn't jumped in yet, and I feel like this is maybe the perfect book to try with them. I'm not a big romance reader, so this is a little bit outside my comfort zone, but I do love romance in like movie forms, and I love romantic comedies. I'm hoping this has that vibe. For the Reindeer Games Readathon, this is gonna fit a book that has red or green on the cover. If you look at the cover, there's some red or green, I think, on the houses. And then for the Reindeer Readathon, I'm gonna put this under the Rudolph prompt, which is a book with a misfit character. And from the synopsis, now I can't exactly remember the synopsis of this book, but I felt like maybe one of the characters is a little bit of like an outcast type person, a little bit of like a free spirit. I think it was the love interest in this book, which is that way. So I hope that counts. Again, I'm not sure this book totally fits that prompt, but I'll have to read it really to find out. The final books that I would really like to finish this month before I get to 2021 is The End of the Anne of Green Gables series. That is Rainbow Valley and Rilla of Ingleside. I really don't want to leave 2021 without finishing this series. I started the Anne of Green Gables series along with Tia and Amanda, who were doing a read-along for it, and I got behind and just didn't pick it up again and just kind of left it by the wayside. So I don't want to leave 2020 without finishing these. And the prompts that I'm hoping these will fit is for reindeer games, read a book you've taken a break from. So I took a break from this series in general, so I hope that counts. And then I'm not sure if it will fit another prompt for the reindeer games readathon. I think I'll have to maybe ask a little bit about that. But for the reindeer readathon, this should work. Companion novel or sequels for the dancer prompt. And then also a book with a map in it, which both of these have maps in them. That's for the prancer prompt. This is probably an incredibly unrealistic TBR for me. I'll probably be lucky if I just finish Rhythm of War, to be honest. But a girl can dream, a girl can try. I just really wanted to be a part of some holiday readathons. I just want to do all the Christmas things this year. I don't know what's gotten into me. I'm not usually quite this enthusiastic, but this year I'm just like, Christmas! Again, all the information for these readathons is down below. Let me know down below in the comments, what are you hoping to read in December? What are you hoping to check off your list before we get into the new year? Please consider subscribing if you would like to keep up with my channel and see what I think about these books. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day and a great reading month. Keep reading great books, and until next time, bye-bye!